Located in the Eastern Caribbean Sea, St. Lucia is a beautiful island nation known for its natural scenery, vibrant culture, and warm hospitality. It's situated about 2,000 miles southeast of Ohio and is a popular destination for tourists from around the world, but especially the US and the UK. St. Lucia is a volcanic island and it's home to the iconic Pitons, which are twin peaks that rise dramatically from the sea and are recognized as a World Heritage Site. The island has lush rainforests, pristine beaches, colorful reefs, and a rich history and culture that is reflected in its music and food. Whether you're looking for adventure or relaxation, St. Lucia has something for everyone. From hiking the peaks to snorkeling in crystal clear waters, this tropical paradise is sure to captivate your senses. So sit back, relax, and watch us explore the beauty of St. Lucia. Once you arrive at Helanora Airport, you have three options to get to Sandals Grand: taxi, ferry, or helicopter. We opted to take the resort taxi to the hotel, which proved to be the only time I've ever felt carsick. The roads weave through mountains, and they drive on the wrong side of the road, which just adds to the chaos. But by the time you get there, the Grand makes you forget just how you got there. As you step out of the taxi, you are cordially greeted by the welcome crew, who immediately hand you a refreshing, ice-cold towel infused with an invigorating scent, washing away all the fatigue of traveling. We're checking in right now. The lobby is an enchanting sight to behold, with breathtaking views of mountains that greet your eyes as soon as you step inside.
We just got escorted to our room. It's super nice. Comes with a fully restocked fridge daily. My favorite part. And they even gave us some dessert with a happy anniversary card.
Voila.
Maybe they think we're married.
Oh, it's chocolate cake. Aw, how cute.
And this is
our patio.
What a view. We just left our room. We're going out to explore for the first time. There's Meg.
Hello, it's been a day.
We had quite the day of travel. We woke up at 1 a.m. and now it's almost 6 p.m. and we just got here.
We haven't had dinner, so we're lunch really. So we're
never
very
had
hungry.
Anything.
Well, we had breakfast at like 4 in the morning.
Barely. I was still hungry. We almost missed our connecting flight in Miami. The drive here was pretty brutal.
It was like over 2 hours.
It's all winding roads through mountains, and they drive on the wrong side of the road, which is pretty crazy. First time I've ever seen that. But this place is 100% worth it.
Oh, it's amazing. We're here. We made it.
The ocean's
after
right
all
out
that
there.
Time. Oh, it's gonna be so beautiful.
Now we're just chilling on this.
And the infinity pool.
Look at that.
Waiting on our bags.
After two flights and a two-hour car drive, when we got back, we had dinner at an Italian restaurant. It was my first time ordering at an all-inclusive resort. I had two appetizers and two entrees. It's really weird walking away without paying, which I kind of like. And then we went and got crepes, and I got some cheesecake too. And now we're going to bed. It's only like 9 o'clock, but we've been up since 1 a.m., so well-needed sleep. See you in the morning. All right, we got 10 hours of sleep. Now we're gonna go grab some breakfast from a buffet, and then I'm gonna water paddleboard?
Yeah, it's paddleboard.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna walk.
Check out that view. This is our view on the way to breakfast. I just keep going back for more plates of breakfast because there's too many options. We just had breakfast at that buffet right there. Then last night, this is where we went to the creperie that also has a little pizza place inside of it. It has cheesecake, crepes, and all other types of dessert.
with some pretty large ships. There's Doug, finding his spot. All right, I just got out on the paddle board. Right now, I'm just on my knees. The view out here is super cool, though. I don't know if you can tell. Yeah, you can see underwater pretty well. This little mountain up here and there, Megan and I are gonna climb probably tomorrow or later today. All right, I'm now standing up. I haven't fallen yet, but I also haven't gone very fast. See all these blue things down in the water, and I'm not exactly sure what they are. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm definitely being swept outward right now.
I just got done paddleboarding for the first time, and the entire time that I was out there, all I wanted to do was get in the water. So I came back to the room, and now I'm gonna go out with some goggles and swim. Megan's gonna come down with me, and we're gonna go meet up with Marcy and Doug.
I'm swimming in the Caribbean for my first time. It's really weird being able to see everything.
I just got in from my first full day here at Sandals Grand. I pretty much spent the entire day in the ocean and laying on the beach, which is pretty weird for me, but when you're in a place with 85 degree crystal clear water, pretty much any water activity you could want, it's hard to pass up. So I just got ready for dinner. Megan will be back soon, and we're gonna grab some food. Today is our third day, our second full day, and we're going to go hike one of the little mountains that's right by our resort.
Let's go.
Sandals Grand St. Lucia is located next to Pigeon Island, a popular tourist attraction in St. Lucia. However, we found out from a local that the island was actually completely disconnected from the mainland prior to the 70s. Our captain was even able to show us a picture taken prior to the dredging. This means the resort is built on ground that didn't exist less than 50 years ago. In the 1970s, the sandbar was officially built up to create a causeway linking the island to the mainland. Pigeon Island has quite a rich history, dating back to the 1550s when it was first used by the French as a military base. That's where we just were. Now we're on our way up there. It was also a key battleground during the infamous battle between the British and the French in the late 1700s, which is where the phrase seven times English and seven times French comes from. That was quite the climb. We're at the top. Our resort is right down here. Today, Pigeon Island is a national landmark and a popular destination for tourists who come to hike its trails and enjoy its beaches. So we just took some of our first professional pictures with my camera since we got here. Right now we're out by the wedding chapel, which is right by the bungalows, which is a pretty fancy villas float on the water.
Mm-hmm. Got a lot of GoPro footage, but...
Yeah, I snorkeled pretty much all day. You can see one of the two little mountains that we climbed. We'll flip it around. Yeah. That is it right there. We were at the top of that. It had a great view. And then these are the... little bungalows I'm talking about that sit on the water.
So we're gonna go eat dinner at like maybe two places.
Yeah, we're probably gonna go to a place called Soy, which is one of two Asian places they have here. What's the plans for tomorrow?
Well, I think you're snorkeling tomorrow. You look so tan.
Oh yeah, I'm going out on the boat tomorrow, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. You get tan snorkeling here in like one day because the UV index is always over...
It's over 10.
It's always over 10, which is rated extreme, yeah. Mm-hmm. So you burn or tan like that. You can kind of see some of the houses in the background that sit on the hills.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
And then the pitons are right over there. You can't really see them.
I would get married here, right in this chapel right here.
Yeah.
That we're right next to.
We're sitting on the chapel. It has a glass floor.
It's beautiful.
Where you walk down the aisle. It's pretty cool.
Oh, gorgeous. I love it.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna go grab some dinner.
Yeah.
We began our day with a swing over the crystal clear water, followed by some exhilarating snorkeling off the beach. While exploring the underwater world, I was ecstatic to find a couple of new fish species and even spotted a fully grown gold-spotted eel. Undoubtedly, the private boat tour was one of the highlights of my trip. Our driver, Terrell, was a treasure trove of knowledge on everything we encountered during the tour. He amazed us with his familiarity with every individual we passed by in the marina. While we sipped on champagne and ate some snacks, Terrell regaled us with fascinating anecdotes about the culture, houses, and boats we encountered. The evening culminated in a breathtaking sunset view, with the boat anchored just off of Pigeon Island, leaving us mesmerized. So I just woke up. Today is Thursday. On Thursday, we started our normal routine by having breakfast at the buffet. We spent the majority of the day relaxing on the beach, and of course, I went snorkeling off the beach. Meg and I did some paddle boarding.
Oh my gosh! You see all the fishies!
And we also sailed together for the first time, which went well, even though I had just learned how to sail not too long before. All of this led up to our private candlelit dinner on the beach. The food was great, our waitress was accommodating, and the view, well, that goes without saying.
This is our first candlelit dinner on a beach, definitely our last too.
Well, we don't know that.
Our table was surrounded by a heart made out of sand, and somehow they put Mr. and Mrs. Hine on our selection handout. The night went great, and we definitely wouldn't pass up on this dinner in the future. On Friday, I went out on a snorkeling excursion with 8 other people to snorkel a reef by Pigeon Island. There was a natural current that swept you in one direction, so I didn't have to do a lot of swimming. I saw more squid, pufferfish, and a really cool blue fish with white spots on it.
Today is St. Patrick's Day. Megan's wearing a green romper. I'm wearing green shorts.
We ended the night by walking out to the wedding chapel at the end of the bungalows and taking some pictures.
This is one of the chapels where you can get married at the resort. It has a glass bottom aisle to walk down, and this is the view looking out.
We then ate dinner with Ed and his wife at Kimono's, which is basically Sandals' version of Soho. This was probably one of my favorite restaurants. Saturday was quite difficult. We started to realize that this was our last day in our new favorite place.
We're both having trouble coping with it.
We spent an hour or so sailing, which went well since it was perfect sailing weather. After that, I ate my last lunch and devoured 5 or 6 pieces of cheesecake. We got dressed and ate at Gordon's on the Water, which had some of the best food there. I couldn't decide if I wanted steak or chicken, so I ordered both. Instead of getting car sick again, I found a local on the beach and negotiated a deal on a ferry ride home. The taxi is free, but Meg and I had not yet seen the pitons from up close, so we had to do it. The boat ride started out awesome. They served us drinks and snacks, the views were amazing, and the breeze felt great. However, when we rounded the corner into the Atlantic Ocean, the water conditions slowly got worse and worse. We eventually had to evacuate the front deck one by one because it was getting to the point where we couldn't even stand up without falling. I'm not gonna lie, I was getting a little nervous as time went on, but I tried to distract myself by thinking about how Doug would complain about this boat ride.
I mean, have I ever led Doug in the wrong direction?
No. I figured it wasn't a good time to tell him that I paid for this ferry for his birthday present. Anyway, we had a long day of travel and ended up getting home around 1 a.m.
It's very sad. We're both struggling with it. With a view like this, it's hard to leave.
God. Visiting St. Lucia was life-changing. I now see why Doug and Marcy visit the Caribbean every month. I spent hours every day in the ocean because it turns out the ocean is actually supposed to be clear and blue. I would like to end this video with a montage of some of my favorite parts. Hope you enjoy.